That exercise you just heard me play allows for every single note to be performed along the span of the entire guitar in a structured and methodical way. So when you have a system like this to practice, you'll perfect the note names and their locations. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to play that exercise and how to use it to improve your knowledge for where every note sits across the neck. But first, before we get started, a quick word about my Handouts Collection ebook offer. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. When it comes to learning notes on the neck, you have to practice a system, because in standard tuning, all the notes on the guitar are laid out in a formulated pattern. So when you have a system to practice those notes, it comes together and makes everything work for you 100%. In the lesson here today, we're going to be using the note of A. We're going to go across the whole neck using A note, and I'm going to show you a two-part system so you can really get the notes on the neck down 100%. Now, the first part of this system uses a string by string approach. Now, on the screen right now, you're going to be seeing an image of the guitar fingerboard lit up with A notes. We're going to start down on the sixth string here at the fifth fret for the first A. The next one's going to be on the 12th fret of the fifth string, and then fourth string, seventh fret, and then over here on the third string, second fret. Next, we're going to go to the second string at 10th fret, and finally up on the top here, we're going to have a fifth fret of first string to finish things off. Now, those are all the locations going in a much more vertical sense across the neck. Once you memorize them and you understand where they are with that one note, my suggestion would be turn on a metronome. I'm gonna spin mine up here at about 100 beats per minute and just play on the beat and get all these notes together. I'm gonna do that right now so you understand what I'm talking about. Here we go. So just up the neck, down the neck, understand where all those locations are. We're really traveling quite vertical because we're just going string by string with this particular method. I did A here in the lesson, but of course you want to do all the notes, you know, every single note, sharps and flats, naturals, all of them. Now, the second part of this method is really kind of interesting because it focuses a little bit more on splitting the neck in half and working within octave ranges. So we're going to have our first range that's going to take place here going from the A on sixth string to A on third, and then A up on the top. So we have a two octave span there that we're dealing with. And then we're going to jump over here from fifth fret to seventh on the fourth string. And then again, this other fifth fret up on top. So that gives us a patterning going like this. All right, and that takes care of the lower end of the neck. Then we're going to jump up to the upper end of the neck here, and we're going to go off seventh fret A on the fourth string. We'll have that note going up here to the 10th fret, second string A. Then we'll jump over here to the 12th fret on the 5th string A, and we'll repeat that 10th fret 2nd string note, repeat the 12th fret 5th string note, and finish just past the 12th fret on 14th fret of the 3rd string. And that gives us a patterning like this. All right, so now we've broken the neck into two sections. We're looking at things much more in an octave-based format, and we're looking at it as, you know, a doubled-up octave concept here in the low end with A's, and then, you know, we're going in single octaves from that point when we go to seventh fret position. And that breaks the neck into two halves. And you can do this with any note. It doesn't have to just be A. You can break the neck into different, you know, portions off of any note that you want. You just have to plot it all out. I'd probably highly recommend you check out a website called The Guitar Scientist. It's a fretboard editor. It's 100% free. Go check it out, and you'll see the address for it pop up on the screen right now. Definitely, you'll get so much benefit out of that, because you'll be able to plot out all your exercises just, you know, right on your computer, right on your screen, and then you can go from there and, you know, print it out, put it on your music stand, and then work on it at home. Now, we're not done yet, though, because I want to fire up the metronome. And I want to go through this octave bass system from the low and the middle and upper registers. So here we go. This is how it's going to work. All right, I'll do it one more time. So it's really important to use a metronome because it's putting you to the test of how well you have practiced and memorized all the locations of those pitches. It's really going to help you a little bit there too with technique and all that jazz. But the main thing is memorization level. If you can play with a metronome, especially up around 100, 120, something like that, you've got it down for sure. So anyway, all you got to do now that you have the two-part system in hand is go forward and learn it really well, be very competent with it in the layouts that I've done with A notes across the neck. And then after that, start going through all the other notes, all the natural tones, all the flats, all the sharps. And by, maybe it will take you 6 weeks, maybe a little bit longer for some people, maybe a little less for others, but you will get this down in a relatively short period of time. Any points at which I've ever taught this to people, they tend to get it down within a three-month period. Even the real, beginner students who've had a lot of challenges, they still get it down within 3 months. So anyway, all this stuff is outlined in my courses over at creativeguitarstudio.com. So if you go over there, you can study the beginner program, the intermediate program. They really get into this quite heavily. My advanced guitar course is a little different because it starts, plotting out positions on the neck with your scales and your arpeggios and getting all those elements together. So it's called the advanced guitar program for a reason, is because it's beyond the basics of just getting your notes down on the fretboard. But check it out over at my website, creativeguitarstudio.com. The handout for this and all the other details for all the other lessons that I post on YouTube are over at my Patreon. So you can go visit over there at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. I want to thank you for joining me today. And if you have trouble learning your notes on the neck, this system is going to be perfect for you. Learning a guitar exercise like this will help get you one step closer to becoming the best guitar player that you can be. To learn more, sign up for a free membership today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.